Alright guys, welcome to episode 4 of Chinok Valley. I'm really excited for this episode. It's going to be the university campus for the area. I realize I'm hitting this kind of early. This is normally something that you would save when you have a bit more population, but we got to the point on the map where I wanted it to be, so I decided we could make it now and the city can grow into it. So that's why we're doing that now instead of waiting a little bit until, you know, we have more population, which leads me to also add in, we will wait to do things like the airport. I'm probably not going to do the airport until we have, at least most of the downtown done when we get to that point. Now that I've gotten that kind of out of the way, I want to apologize. I know I am very behind. This is Tuesday night when I'm recording this this time-lapse audio, meaning that I am now 5 days behind when I was supposed to post the video, and 4 days behind when I told you on Twitter I was going to. So I am very sorry. And at this rate, it probably won't even be up on YouTube until Wednesday. Because rendering takes a few hours, and then uploading to YouTube takes a few hours, and then it takes an hour to process, and it's just a long process that takes time. Not to mention the fact that I'm not even done editing yet. So realistically, Wednesday is hopefully when it will be up. My goal is to have most of the editing done tonight, which is why I'm recording this time-lapse audio now. Again, very, 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 very sorry about that, guys. I really, really apologize. For those of you that didn't know that I posted it would be late on Twitter, you should follow me on Twitter, at cogwheel_YT. That is where you get most of the up-to-date information from me. I post teaser pictures there as well. And I can also, I also happily interact with you guys on Twitter. I love hearing your ideas. I mean, the idea for this university, I came from a YouTube comment. I actually don't remember who commented, but you know what, I can find out, because I have it up right now. I love hearing ideas for what you guys think, and what you guys think I should do, because I really do take your input, and I want you guys to enjoy what I'm throwing up here. And just so I can feel good about myself, the person who told me I should build a university, that is going to be a fun one to pronounce. Bibutinus? Bibutinus? I am ruining your name, and I am very, very sorry. I also want to thank everyone who commented on my videos and who's been subscribing recently. I'm at 19-20 subscribers as of right now, which is awesome. Only 3 episodes in, technically, on my 4th one right now, and already at 20 subscribers. I'm really excited about that. I'm definitely seeing some good comments. I also want to thank people like Prez who've commented on my video. I appreciate the kind words. It really is kind of what keeps me going. Knowing you guys are liking what I'm doing, which segues me into talking about this. I wanted to get this video out for you guys, which means I didn't get as detailed as I would have liked to have. Reason being, I was on vacation, and then I came back and I was sick. Of course, I got sick on vacation, so I came back and I was dealing with that. And coming back to work, already having been a few days behind because of my vacation, and then catching up because I was sick. So, long story short, things got kind of behind. So that is the reason why everything is so delayed. So with that being said, I want to mention that I'm not going to be able to do as much detail as I would normally do, because I wanted to get some video up here for you guys. I wanted you guys to see what I've been working on. So just to let you know, it's not going to get, you'll see me do some detailing. I'm definitely going to detail the university a bit. I'm going to detail the student apartment complex that we make quite a bit. But I'm not going to be able to detail everything, which I'm actually happy with, because I didn't want to rush it. So I have a feeling we're going to be on this campus and this part of Chinook Valley. This town that kind of surrounds the college We'll probably be on this for another two or three episodes after this one, probably two episodes after this one, getting it nice and pretty and awesome. That's what I'm at least feeling. And the reason being is I want this to be kind of not the gem of Chinook Valley, but it's going to be a really pretty part of Chinook Valley. I really want it to shine because, you know, like these universities in these southern rural towns always do. They're always beautiful. They're always just awesome. Like, I mean, I mentioned I went to Auburn, which is a beautiful southern campus. I'm modeling this after UVA quite a bit. Beautiful southern campus. And I want that feeling in Chinook Valley. So we're going to be on this one for a while. I also realize that I'm cutting this kind of early for having a diversity. So, yeah. So hopefully the region grows into it. Yeah, we'll see. So with that being said, like I said, we're going to focus on the foundation for the university. We're going to detail it just a little bit. We're going to get it working. Then we build a kind of student apartment complex not far away from the campus for the kids that live off campus that would commute on to campus. And that's what we're doing for this episode. In the next episode, we'll probably do some commercial districts like bookstores and Walmarts and Krogers and stuff like that for the town. And then what we'll do is we'll build out like houses for the faculty and that kind of stuff so that they have a place that they can that live, you know, like think like, you know, where would the professors live, that kind of stuff. So we'll build like kind of a more upscale residential area, and then we'll have like some other residential areas that maybe look a little bit more run down for people who maybe work on campus. And then obviously, you know, areas for students to rent out. Not every student is going to live in an on-campus or in an apartment complex. Some will have nicer homes. Some will live in maybe duplexes or so on and so forth. So we'll kind of get that that whole thing going. And then obviously we'll design a bus system for the university. And then we'll probably link up the train station that we put in Carroll Pass up with whatever town that I decide to call this. Which reminds me, right now the college is called Valley University. That's the title of this episode. I don't know if I love that. So why don't you guys go ahead and give me some ideas for what to call the university? I'd love to hear what you guys think. You know, feel free to comment on the video, or feel free to hit me up on Twitter to let me know what your ideas are for what to call the university. I was thinking about making up a name and like naming it after a person who's on that statue that we just placed. It really couldn't come up with anything. So right now it's just Valley University, which is why there was a V in front of the stadium. If we change the name of the college, I might leave the V because it's really pretty, and just maybe we'll just call the V for victory. Who knows? I really liked the way the university came out. There's a nice, awesome tailgate lawn that you'll see. The symmetry of the university, at least in the quad area, is really cool looking. So it came out quite nice. So I'm going to go ahead and say again, follow me on Twitter, guys. That's going to be your best way to get in touch with me, to kind of give me your ideas and keep up to date with what's happening. Also, you'll see we kind of go in and, you know, about to detail the sports complex. So what I'm going to do is there's only a couple minutes left of the time lapse. I'm going to stop rambling, and so I'll just leave you with a little bit of music while the time lapse finishes up, and then I will see you all back in the live mode. I was planning on doing some more building afterwards, but we ran out of time, so it'll end after the live mode with some cinematics. I did some work off camera between the end of the live mode and the cinematics, so you guys will get to see kind of what we've built. And then when we come in for episode 5, I'll give you guys a tour of everything that was done off camera, and then we'll go from there. I'm still not sure what format that is. I'm not even done editing episode 4, obviously. So why don't you guys just enjoy the rest of the time lapse, and I'll see you in the live mode. guys, and welcome back to Live Mode. So we're looking over the creation, looking over Valley University, as it were. I took a lot of inspiration from a couple different campuses, mostly southern campuses, which would be kind of obvious. So like you'll see a heavy like UVA influence here, with a little bit of where I went. I went to Auburn, a lot of Auburn kind of thrown in, kind of with this ag research area. My idea is that Valley University is a land grant university. So and what that means is that it was actually, you know, the grant was given by the federal government, meaning they had to do research for things that promoted the public well-being, so agriculture research or you know, like livestock research, that kind of stuff. So yes, we kind of did that. I love the way this turned out. We have our entry road coming up. National road turns into a grass-lined road. We get our tree lined as we come up into the kind of entry road. I love how the statue fits just right here. We have the car path and the promenade path for bikes, which I really like a lot. So obviously the encompassing road, which leads off to parking for students who live on campus, and then, like, you know, you have the quad, upper and lower quad here, which I think came out really well. We have some spaces for picnicking and a nice, you know, a very symmetrical quad, which is very, very typical of these kind of things. And you'll notice that I followed heavy symmetry. I really wanted this to be very symmetrical while being slightly asymmetric, but I wanted the building layout to be very symmetrical. So while not everything matches, everything looks like if a building was placed here, a building had to be placed here. If a building was placed here, it had to be placed here. And that's how you kind of get it to look very campusy, because college campuses tend to have like some kind of building requirement or like structure to their architecture. So like at Auburn, every building that was built on campus had to be a certain percent, certain color of brick, like so that every building kind of matched, which is why I went with these 50-person campus dorms. I think they look really, really awesome, actually, especially if you're like on the promenade here. Like, I mean, just... doesn't that look so cool? And like, actually, you know what? This actually might happen. I might actually, and screenshot. Yep, that just happened. That might actually be your teaser for this episode. And I love how it comes to these like wings here. And I think that looks really, really, really cool. So there is one more thing I wanted to do, and I'm trying to figure out where to put it, and I think I just figured it out. I was on the assets, the Steam Workshop, and I found a couple... Maybe I didn't. I thought I found a couple assets, at least I thought I did, for... for a president's house. Maybe I didn't download them. Maybe I am going crazy. That is an entire possibility. Let's just do a quick search here, see if they're in the parks, and it's just a name that I'm not recalling here. Quickity quick, quick, quick. I might edit this out. Not there either. Alrighty, well, apparently I didn't get the thing that I thought I did, which really isn't that big of a deal. I just kind of sad. Unless it's in here somewhere. It might be. No. Okay, that's fine. That just means that I'm going to have to find it. Again, I thought I downloaded it, but, you know, it doesn't actually matter all that much. I mean, I'm sure I can download it, and I'll show it to you guys at the end in the cinematics. I'm sure I'll figure out what happened to it, or figure out why I didn't download it. Something along those lines. It's, what's that? Driving range. Interesting. Yeah, okay. Doesn't matter. But I think I'm gonna put it right here. I think that'll look really, really cool. Especially with the statue there. Maybe like mansion, fountain behind it, and then we'll like put a fence. Yeah, that actually sounds really cool. I need to remember to do that. So, just so I don't forget, let's go ahead and put a district so I don't forget. President's house. Cool. Okay. That way I won't forget. But, so this is going into what I wanted to do for this live. Well, actually, we'll go ahead and show off a couple more things. I love how this stadium turned out. Like, I have the parking lots, obviously, big parking area. I love this. I'm like the lawn. I think that's a really cool. I'm stealing that from UVA. I don't care. That was really, really cool. So I'm calling this the lawn, even though they kind of call their quad the lawn. But the lawn is like where you would tailgate for your sporting events, which is why all these event tents are out here. I will probably come back in and like lay down some like tables and stuff, just so it kind of looks a bit better when you zoom in. But I found for right now, this is what I'm happy with this. I'm really loving the way this came out. Like, I'm calling this. I don't have the mob where you can name streets, but I will eventually, and I'm going to call this Victory Way, so that it comes around the gigantic, gigantic football stadium. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, like this is just huge for a college. I mean, to be fair, like again, I'm from the South, so this isn't that big, but maybe I mean, you know, it probably is. Which I love here, like, and I love how like there's a stadiums across this side of campus. I really like the way that came out. I love this, like, how this V came out for Valley University. I think it looks really, really cool. I don't know if I want to get more landscaped with this. I think like this would be like that's it. Like, I don't think there would be anything else in here. Maybe some other colors just to kind of make it pop a bit more. But I'm really happy the way that came out. Well, and since this is probably way more parking than this will need, I'll probably have to throw in some cars here, even though that might clip. And then I like the way this came out. These is like the agriculture research. I've using the botanical garden there to kind of mark off like a greenhouse. And then I loved this idea. So like we have over in Cooper, we have our paper plant. So my thought was like maybe like they have a research deal with the university here to research different types of trees that can be grown for paper. And then we have like the different agricultural fields here for doing different kinds of research. I really like the way that came out. And then so you'll see here, this is like parking for the students that live on campus. This will all work too, which I'm really happy about because, you know, this is going to be a huge, like this is going to handle a lot of students. You'll definitely get a lot of use out of this. Here we have the main clock tower building, and we have the library on the backside of the university, which I think looks really cool back there. All right. Now that we've done that tour of the university, I want to hop into a live build. And the live build, we're going to do a couple apartment complexes. We'll probably lay down the foundations for our like Walmart and some stores. Kind of obviously, a town around a university tends to be not heavily populated, but definitely, you know, it has the things to support a student community and a faculty community. So we'll come through and we'll do a little bit of that. But what we're going to start off right now is I want to lay down this apartment complex, and I really like some of the stuff I found. So this is the apartment complex. I can't remember who made this, and I wish I did because I would love to shout them out. But regardless, so this is I think this is a really cool asset. And so what I'm going to do is I lay down like this is like. I'm considering this one big apartment community, and then like this will be like different like wings and sections of the building. So I'm gonna try and clip it together without looking stupid. So we're gonna see what we can come up with over here, and then we'll mimic that across the board. So we're gonna have to use Move It definitely. So let's see what we can clip together to make this look right. And let's see, how does that look dumb? You know, I think the ground level for the height is going to be an issue. So here's what we're going to do. Let's level this out just so it's not an issue because I really want these to clip together. I think that'll be the best way we can get this to look. So let's just level it out a bit and then obviously we'll fix it once we're finished. So let's lay back down our lines. How we did it here. And all I'm really doing is trying to, I'm just getting a similar angle to, you know, what we're coming in on, but I definitely wanted it to kind of have its own feel. Okay, so there we go with that. And now let's see if we can get this to lay the way that we want it again. I don't think I laid that in the right spot. So we have that. If we put that there and we put that there, not a fan. Alright, so what happens if we put this? I wish it wouldn't snap like that. It's unfortunate that it's gonna be that way. Let's see if I can. How does that look? Does that look terrible? And if we move it. So that lines up there. What does that look like? It's not terrible, but I'm not happy with it. Okay, so those line up there now, but I really want the peaks to be pretty spot on. Alright, so that's pretty spot on with that peak. How does that look there? It has to look in the back, because that's really going to be where this... Oh! You know, that actually came out not being half bad. Alright, that was lucky. That's what we're going to call that. But since I used to move it, nothing is going to match anymore. So let's lay that down, and then we're going to move it. It's too much. There we go. That, I think, looks good. Yeah, that looks nice. Goes together really nicely, I feel like. Yeah, and then I'll lay down another one. How does that look? Does that look crazy? Actually, I feel like that... Ooh. Yeah, there's an issue back there. But I like the way it looks in the front enough. Not... You know what, actually? Do this. I'm going to do something in the middle. So in order to get access, what we'll do is I'll leave that open there. And then we'll bring that there. I'm going to have to move that. Get that peak lined up again. Perfect. Yeah, that lines up nicely. Lines up nicely in the back. And then what we'll do is we'll do the same thing here. And that was there. So that goes there. Alright, move it again. Alright, and if we lay one right in the middle, what happens? It's not terrible. Let's see if I'm missing something. Back there looks okay. I don't see any doubling up, and I might just be missing it, but I think that looks okay. So what we'll do is we'll lay this one here. No, actually, how did that come out? And we'll move it. Okay, that's too far apart, isn't it? Especially if I want, yeah, so those are pretty much touching. Okay, so just bring it over a little bit. There we go. I think that's what we want. Yep, that's exactly where I want it. Okay, that looks really nice. I'm happy with the way that turned out. So now, obviously we need some parking. So what we'll do is we'll lay down some parking here on the corners. So let's see, 2x4, 2x2 maybe might fit. And if we use move it, can we get that to be where we want it to be? Yes, perfect. All right, so we'll just do the same thing on every corner here. We'll do it on those two corners at least. Move it up. All right. That's definitely good enough. I feel like for, not enough parking obviously, but I think that'll be good for what we're trying to do. And then what we'll do is we'll line. So is that 2, 4, 6, 8, call it 10. 10x4 lot right there. We move it once, twice. And then we do the same thing over here. Move it twice. Yep, that pretty symmetric there. And I think that's probably enough parking for this place. 'Cause I kind of want to have a few more buildings to wrap around. I think that would be cool. Plus, we really, really need some residential, like if we don't have enough. So now what I'll do is, these will be separate buildings. I think that would look nice. We'll just have these being like these are the more expensive ones, you know, they're a bit separated, you get a bit more privacy. I think that'll look really cool. And we'll lay some parking here. What is that? Looks like a 4x4? Can we get a 4x4 in there? Yes, we can. Alright. So, obviously, this is not detailed at all. And so, what I'll do is we'll work on this one on camera. We'll do the other ones off camera, but they'll all be exactly mirrored. With exactly what we're doing here. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to lay a path, concrete path, that we'll walk back here. And we'll just turn back on anarchy, so boom, it clips in that way. And then, so now we have a pathway, and I have a way I can lay down some concrete. Let's turn that off. Let's lay down a pool first. I'm thinking these apartment complexes for the colleges always have a pool. So we'll do a big pool here. Let's see. You know, that's not right. That's centered. And I think it looks better. Yes, it does. Okay, so now we can use that as a guide for our pool. Want it to be right about there. Perfect. And what we'll do is we will concrete this whole area. Make some concrete there, concrete, and just concrete up this whole area, and we'll just concrete up the path as well, just so it looks right. We don't get that craziness. And just more concrete. This is going to be a very concrete area. And obviously we'll lay down some planters. Actually, what happens if we do that? No, what happens if we do... That looks relatively centered. And it gives us a decent little green space there for us to play with, which I think is something we definitely need. And then... An angle is too much of an angle. Yeah. You know, let's just come out square with the building. Yeah. Yeah, that looks good. Okay. So we have our pool, which I think looks really nice. What we'll do is these places normally have a fence, but I don't think I want to do that. Or should I? They do normally have a fence at these entrances. I wonder if I have a fence that makes sense. Do I have a gate of some kind, like a pretty gate? I think all I have is the crappy looking chain link fence gates or the driving gate. Maybe I can make one with a pretty fence. Let's see, what do I have? Pretty fences, pretty fences. Picket fence, iron fence. Yeah, I think this one might actually work. So what we'll do is we'll bring a line and fence mode. And we're going to need to turn on the anarchy. It's already on. All right, so got that one. And what we'll do is we'll make it look like the gate is open just by deleting one of these and then placing it just kind of as if it was opened. I need to zoom in a little bit though. I can't see. Close enough. And then we'll delete this one. And we'll do the same thing. We'll make this one open the other way. All right. There we go. We got a little fence. That way people who don't live here can't come and access the pool like they're not supposed to. So I'm thinking in this green space, we'll do a nice southern live oak, give it a lot of shade. Apparently we still have the brush on. We'll turn that off. Single. So the only thing about searching for trees is that it keeps like the most recently used one we do, which is not always what you want. Okay, so we have that, and let's dress it up with our bush and our flowers like we always do. Bush number 8, so put 1, 2, 3, 4, and realize I'm probably don't need to count out like that, but I think, so one there, and I really love this purple, and I love how I was able to bring it into the university too. Like, you'll note, like, the university, in my mind, the colors are pink and yellow, which are probably just awful, awful colors, or purple and yellow, for, like, a football team. They probably just figure it's just, like, the girliest girly colors, but, you know, whatever. I think they complement each other enough in that V that they really outshine, and the purple is definitely the color of the region, so. All right, so that's good there. Now what we'll do is we'll do the dirt decal to kind of dress it up just a tad, as if, like, you know, some of that dirt's been out there. I think that comes off really nice. And then where's our fallen leaves? Because those look really nice. There, there, and yes. That looks nice. And then what we'll do is we'll put some tables out here, because obviously this is, you know, you'd come out here and do your homework, or you kind of do whatever. We'll do this rustic table. I think they're the same, but so we'll put one there and we'll put another one on the other side, following that some symmetry They're going with there. Ooh, that is just off. You know what? Screw that. I don't like that idea anymore. We'll just kind of place them randomly out here. I think that'll be the better bet. At least the ones over here. There we go. And then we will put one. There in front of that window. There in front of that window. I think that looks good. And then we'll do one. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I think that's perfect. So then what we can do is we'll use the parasol to put some shade over these things. Kind of give it a better look. And then I want to put a parasol there. Great. Perfect. I think that looks really nice. And the question is, do I have any lawn chairs? Or is that going to be... I really, you know, I doubt I do, but, you know, we're just going to see. Maybe I do. Ooh, I do. So we can lay some more of these around. I want these to kind of be, that's what we'll do, we'll turn off the fence mode, and we will set these at a 45 angle, yeah, I like that, but our spacing is off, so let's bring some more. Perfect. All right. Got some more chairs back there. We'll do some more parasols. What is this? Ooh, I think that'll look perfect for this piece over here. So we'll just put one there and one there. Obviously, you're going to want some sun. And then what's that one look like? Yeah, okay. And so now what we'll do is we will make this concrete look more like a college campus, so there'll be some cracks in it. So let's find some cracks. Or you know what? Not the cracks, but we should do puddles, especially around the pool here. Yeah, that looks really good. And then we'll put some more puddles over there and over there. How does that look? Yes, got some texture. And then stains? No, I don't think we need stains. Got the dirt already, so that's good. Alright, I think that looks nice. So what we'll do now is we'll lay down some bollards at these paths, because obviously you don't want cars driving up them. So we'll just do that there. Is anarchy on still? Perfect. And let's just see how that looks at night. Nice, I like that a lot. And what we'll also do is we'll put some lights back here, since we definitely need some. How does this one? That's way too bright, I think. Let's see, can we get... Ooh, you know what, I wonder how... If that fits over... No, it doesn't fit over the pool. Does that one? That one does. I'm not happy with the way that looks, so we're not going to use that. Let's see, maybe we can find some nicer looking one there, one there. I think that's definitely better. It definitely lights it up. So then we should also do, this is way too dark over here, so we'll put one there. And I think that might actually light it up. Yeah, that lights up the area decently. Not too much, I feel. Yeah. And then what we'll do is we'll put one there. There. And there. Obviously the ballers light that up, so that's decent. And then we'll put one in the middle of these two, because we don't want to overwhelm with these lights. That's not what we want to do. And then what we'll do here is we'll put a normal street lamp. I think yellow would look good. Yeah, yellow looks great there on that intersection. So now. Yes, that's much better for nighttime. I don't like that the street lamps on the parking lots don't work. But oh well. I think we have enough. I think, actually, no, we don't have enough, but let's just do it. Let's fix that problem while I'm standing here. Well, not standing here, but as we're doing it. I don't want it to be too bright, so, and if we do those, they'll be really, really bright, won't they? Those double-headed yellows, which I think is what that is, isn't it? No, it's not. What is it? Definitely not that one. Let's see, what are those lights? This is going to drive me crazy. They're probably one of the built-in ones that I just don't even have the time to look for. So what we'll do is we'll just lay down the yellow ones. Where they go. That is so bright, though. You know what? We're only going to do one. I don't like how bright it makes it if we do two. I only want the one of it back. You know, watch it. I'm going to lay down these lights and then these other ones will start working and that'll be a pain in the annoying thing. And then I definitely want the white. I think I want that white over here. It's really bright, but we'll deal with it. No, actually, it's not terrible. It's not too bright. I don't like it, but I think once I lay some trees around the edges, it might not look as crazy. So yeah, it's not bad. Also, I'm just noticing. I think I had anarchy on when I laid down these buildings, and I did not notice. So fix that real quick. And what we'll do here is we'll just kind of connect this up with a path so that it looks as if, you know, it's kind of designed. That's not looking the way that I want it. Let's see, can we do that? And then perfect. There we go. Yeah, that looks good. So we'll just do the same thing over here, just to kind of make this look like it's not just come out of nowhere. Yeah, much better. And then we'll do the same thing over here. Cool. All right. And then I think what we'll do is we will also do this. Just to kind of connect in these other sides. And then we'll connect that with this parking lot. And we'll do the same thing over here, just to kind of give it, you know, so people can walk to the parking lot. It also kind of gives it a better shape. And then we'll use those planners that have the triangle shape to them, if I can find them. I don't know what they're called, though. What is this called? Solden. And so what we'll do is we'll get that set up here. Yeah, that's not very big, is it? Crap, I thought that would look better. Let's see, what about the other? No, crap. If I can't get the planters, then we'll just lay some trees down. Well, you know what? That doesn't... I wonder if you can move it down so it's not in the street. Can you do that? Probably not. No, you can't. I can move that up, though. Nope, that doesn't do what I wanted it to do. Alright. That actually doesn't look too bad. You can barely see it there. So, and I think it gives a nice structure to the edge, so I definitely want to keep it. That one's a bit more noticeable, but I think if we put our trees in it, like I'm looking, like I'm going to do, it probably won't be as noticeable. Yeah, it won't be. So that we'll get... decent. Yeah, that looks decent. And then what we'll do is, you know, we'll do the planters kind of all the way around. That way we get some edge to our parking lot here. So we'll put that there. Do these along the road. Yeah, I like these because you can really overlap them. It definitely looks good. And then, cool. So now we can do our oak. There we go. And that looks nice. We'll do some more planters over here on this side, and I think what we'll get is a really nice looking parking lot for these students, which is definitely what you want. You definitely want them to have a nice parking lot. You want it to look right too, so there we go. And we'll lay this one down there. And these will function too, which is why that'll be really nice. Alright, so now we have some nice planters there. What we'll do is we'll put another one over here just to kind of give it a nice edge. This is going to fit perfectly right there, isn't it? Do our oaks, and then I'm thinking we'll probably line the pathways with a bush of some kind. I think that will look nice. Also, I don't like how that line tool only gave us so many, so I'm just going to manually throw in one on the end and one in the middle. No, actually, screw the one in the middle. We have our light there. Yeah, that looks good. And then I'm trying to think if we should do some kind of gate or flower bed or this. This actually might be our best bet. Gives a nice transition out of the back. Maybe white people, you know, are smoking a cigarette out here, or doing whatever it is that you would do out the back of your building. Yeah, I think that looks good. We'll do the same over here. And then I think this side will actually look better too because it's already got some trees to kind of give it that feel that we're going for. So what we'll do now is we will bring back our oak. And we'll just do some clusters of trees. Over here, put some there. Think that looks really nice. And then what I want to do here is we'll lay down some bushes. Let's see how that. No, that's not gonna. Do a bush there and a bush there. Nah, I don't like the way that looks. If there's any kind of bush, it would be by the front door. But I don't want to do a giant one. I think for now I'll leave it, and I'll probably come back and take a look. But I think for now, I'm mostly happy with the way this has come out. Yeah, definitely. Definitely happy with the way that came out. Just let that sim run for a second because I'm really curious to see. Oh, yeah, it doesn't have any water. No. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is we'll just drag the water pipe over here so that the place can have some water. And then it also has no power, but. Okay. All right. So what I'll do is I'll do these off camera and get it nice and matched up, and then you'll connect them with some pathways, which is what the whole point of this was for. And I think this community will look really awesome. So I'll be back on the other side. Hey guys, welcome to the closing cinematics. I know you just heard me say that I will see you in a live mode after some work. On camera, unfortunately, we ran out of time. During editing, I realized we were already at 55 minutes. There was no way I was going to fit another live mode build in with some detailing. So like I said at the beginning of the video, what we're going to be doing is you're going to be flying over looking at some of the stuff I built off camera. But we're going to come back to this area in the next video to do a lot of detailing. You've just seen the foundation for the entire part of this map. And like I said, I really want this area to shine. So I hope you guys enjoy the cinematics of what I'm calling the Valley University Foundation. We're going to get a lot more into the weeds. And I hope you guys enjoy it. So enjoy the rest of the cinematics, and I will see you guys in episode 5.